it's time to start my story! This game's protagonist has to be me, after all. Whew! I'm finally here! Seriously, though, this tower is super gilded. And now that I'm getting a good look at it from down here, this thing is gigantic! I know! If it's this huge, I bet the view from up top is amazing! If I just shimmy up this thing, I'm sure I'll know where I am. I'm so smart. All right, open sesame! Hey, wait just a sec. It won't open, no matter how hard I push or pull. Ooh, I get it. The joke's that it was a sliding door this whole time, right? Guess not. If I transformed, I could fly all the way up. But I can't seem to do that. It might be because of the damage from the brawl with Goldbird. I'm not giving up just because I can't transform. If I can't climb from the inside, then I just gotta scale the outside. Tower climbing, here I go!
So, this is the Golden Summit. As a tower enthusiast, I'd love to go in, but work comes first. It seems worth trying to climb it, though. Maybe I'll come back if I get some vacation time.
Ah!
Hmm? What is that? Someone's voice? But from where?
I'm falling! Move, 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 move!
Wait, from above? Why is that kid falling from the sky?
Kid? I can say the same thing about you, Squirt! Who are you, anyway?
The name's IF. I'm a gust of wind blowing through...
Wait! It's Iffy! To think I'd reunite with you like this, Iffy! It reminds me of the first time we met. If I remember, I accidentally slipped off the top floor of the true Neptural Tower and landed right in front of you.
Who the heck are you? And how do you know my nickname?
Aw, come on. Don't you think that's pretty cold, even coming from you, Iffy? I didn't mean to disappear from the arena so suddenly, so I don't think it's right of you to get angry over it.
What in the world are you saying? Did you hit your head when you fell? Do you have a concussion right now? Because if you do, I'm gonna need to call an ambulance to take you to a hospital.
Not cool, Iffy. Even I could get angry if you keep poking fun at me like that.
This girl's no good. Maybe it's because she hit her head so hard, but everything she's saying is complete garbage.
Huh? Just a minute. You're not angry and you're not pulling my leg?
I'm not angry and I'm not joking at all. Jeez, you're a rude person.
That sounded like a serious reaction.
Sounds like? It is a serious reaction, weirdo! But that's a relief. You can actually hold a normal conversation. For some reason, I don't see any injuries on you either. So, I'll be going. I'm in the middle of a job right now. Oh, I know. Since you're here, I'd like to ask you for help with my investigation. Have you seen anyone suspicious around here?
A suspicious person?
Yeah, like a really suspicious old lady.
Nope, I haven't seen anything.
Crap! That probably means it was a hoax.
Something wrong with this lady? If you're after her, Iffy, then she must have done something bad.
I can't give you all the details, but she's the perpetrator of several thefts. I came here after looking into a few eyewitness testimonies, but I guess they were cold leads. I better head back to the Basilicom and investigate some more before I make a move.
The Basilicom? That means you're going to Platitoon, right?
Yeah, but, well, it'd be a problem to leave a kid in a place like this. Why don't you come with me?
Yeah, I'll tag along.
You should be fine here. By the way, there's no way you're not injured after that fall, so you need to get over to the hospital ASAP. Got it?
You heading to the Basilicom, Iffy?
That's what I was thinking, but there's a change of plans. I'm gonna gather some more info here before heading out.
Oh, cool. So do you think Guy could?
Nope. Don't need your help.
Aww.
This is my job. I can't let a kid like you just shadow me into some dangerous situations. I'm sure you'd just get in the way anyhow.
You're so stingy.
Yeah, sure thing. Just get yourself to the hospital, all right?
Okay, fine. Now then, putting aside the fact that Iffy doesn't know who I am, I made it to Planetoon, so I should figure out what the heck's going on around here.
Thank you. Bud? Who are you?
Don't be silly. It's me, Neptune. N-E-P-T-U-N-E.
Neptune? I don't know that name.
Oh, not again. You and Iffy tell the meanest jokes. Oh, I get it. You guys are planning a surprise party for me, so you're being mean on purpose.
This is Lady Bisha's holy basilicum. I will not allow you to make a mockery of it, even if you are but a child. I will not go easy on you.
Just hang on a second, will ya? Who's Lady Bisha? This is my basilicum, isn't it?
Good grief, what a noisy child. Leave this basilicum at once.
Huh? Wait, what?
Excuse me, but what's going on here? The level of noise is quite unacceptable.
Oh, Lady Eastwar. This child is causing a ruckus, trying to force her way inside the basilicum.
Child? Why, Neptune, is that you?
Isti? Isti, you haven't forgotten me!
How could I possibly forget you? Oh, goodness, I never thought I would see you again.
Oh, Isti, me too! Iffy, the citizens, and everyone else don't know who I am! I was super lonely.
Lady Eastwar? Is this an acquaintance of yours?
Yes. She is a very old friend of mine. Please, allow me to look after her.
Understood.
Come, Neptune. Let's not stand around here. We will retire to the back to speak at length.
So what in the hay's going on around here?
To be honest, I am not completely sure. However, it is certain that the existence of CPUs has been erased from the collective memory of game industry's population.
So, that's why everyone was acting like they just had met me. Wait, then how do you remember me, Isti?
This is only a theory, but it may be because I was created artificially to record Planetune's history. I believe this phenomenon occurred because some unknown power somehow altered the entire history of game industry. That may be why the Gold Third is currently presiding over this world, and the CPUs are entirely non-existent.
Ah, I see.
There are several distinct changes. The first is the appearance of monsters. They are ferocious and have never actually been identified before. They're entirely new and their numbers are increasing rapidly. There are also reports of a strange phenomenon where some monsters suddenly become violent. In the past, there were cases of monsters being polluted via the deity of sin's miasma. But this is a separate anomaly. Since they attack others indiscriminately, we are calling them delusionary monsters. They are currently under investigation. The second change here is that organizations are using their existence as an excuse to skirmish with other factions senselessly. It has not escalated to full-blown national war, but its scale is slowly increasing. The most serious threat, however, is the group said to be manipulating all of this from the shadows.
You're talking about Affymax, right?
How do you know that name? That information is being meticulously controlled.
Oh, I just saw it on an N-chan thread.
Oh, on the internet? Has the information leaked?
Oh, don't be silly. It's N-chan we're talking about here. So what's Affymax up to? When I asked on N-chan, people said they didn't want to talk about it. They told me to stop baiting and go back to Nepit. Ooh.
Affymax. Reports have indicated that they steal business technology and information, sell it to others, and are the ones spreading the war.
So Sounds kind of like those mastermind orgs in anime and games that start wars to make a profit by selling weapons and supplies.
It is precisely that.
Still, just because there are no CPUs, how did the world get so dangerous? Hey, that also means that all those people complaining about us being incompetent were totally wrong. Eat that!
That may be so. Recalling those times now, I feel they were by far the most peaceful.
By the way, where is the gold third member that's ruling over Planetune in my place?
Well, I am not sure what caused this twist of fate, but she slacks off just as much as you do, and is out today as well. Why is it that those in charge of Planetune never like to work in the slightest? Oh, of course! If Bisha refuses to work, then I can simply have you take her place, Neptune.
What? How'd you come to that conclusion?
The world is in disorder because of these conflicts. This is the time you must fulfill your duties as a CPU.
What?
I will not hear any complaints. Planetune, no. The entirety of game industry is facing a crisis.
Then, can I go help out Iffy?
Help IF? But she does not remember.
Yeah, I know. I met her earlier.
Is it not painful?
Yeah, it is. But it can't be helped. Besides, she might remember me if I hang out with her enough, you know? From your story, Isti, it sounds like Iffy's taking on Appymax alone, and I don't think that's the safest thing for her to be doing.
You are right. We have no idea what the outcome may be, so I will permit you to accompany her.
Woohoo!
However, you must not get in her way. Understood?
Thank you. energy.
A kangaroo! Jump! Boing! Jump! Like a kangaroo! Hey! Can't see me! wonder what's inside. Jump! Like a kangaroo! Boing! Boing! Jump! Boing! Boing! Like a kangaroo!
Formidable. Here we go.
Thank you. Leave this to me. attack head on!
Not bad. Ruin to all!
This is nothing!
Leave things to me!
Ruin to all!
Ouch!
My turn!
The time of the apocalypse is now!
I'll get victory on this one blow!
Not bad!
You're finished!
Leave things to me! My blood's boiling! Demonic Inferno!
The time of the apocalypse is now!
This is nothing!
Oh, my turn!
Ruin to all!
Let's end this!
Leave things to me!
Will I be defeated? My wounds! Your tenure, that was a clumsy fight.
Together.
Yeah, between the festival and dealing with Affymax, we've been working 24/7.
I heard they popped up in Last Station recently.
Right. If I recall, what got stolen over there was some company's documents and research about some of their patents.
Didn't Arbor steal a game console before that, too?
Yep, for some reason, Affymax keeps stealing Planetunian game consoles. I don't really know what's up with that. But people are starting to joke that the game consoles are the most valuable thing Planetune has to offer. Seriously, I have no idea what they're planning with that. Such a weird move.
Ooh! A used game shop in a place like this? Chuko's super rare secondhand shop. Sounds like there might be some bargains. Let's take a peek.
Oh, that shop. It opened pretty recently. They sell mostly a bunch of retro consoles and games.
Be still, my beating heart. I have a feeling that a retro treasure exists within these walls.
I can't believe this happened.
Miss Sales Clerk Mouse? Is something wrong?
Oh, customers! Hello! Welcome to my shop! Actually, I'm sorry. I'm all closed up today.
Closed? Did something happen?
Yes, something awful. You see, all of my game merchandise was stolen.
Could the culprit possibly be the secret organization?
Highly probable. So, did you report this to the police?
I just finished doing that.
Okay, that's good. Then, could you let us in on all the details? My name's Aya. I work for the Basilicon. These other two are Neptune and Kampa.
Nice to meet you. I'm the manager of the store, Chuko.
That's an adorable name. It's nice to meet you, too.
I see. So when you came to work, the store was already in this state. And all of your used games and consoles had already been stolen from your shop.
Are used consoles and games valuable enough to warrant stealing them?
They aren't all that expensive, so I can't believe they're really worth it.
You guys don't understand the high values placed on retro games. It's these kind of titles that core fans keep forever because they're not made anymore. They can go for 10 times their original price.
10 times?
Oh, that's nothing. Some games produced in small quantities might sell for over 100 times the original price.
100? But does anyone even buy them for that much?
Oh, Kampa, you don't get it. It's a pretty good look to have games like that in the shop, even if no one ever actually buys them. Just by having them on display, lots of customers will roll in from curiosity or thinking that the shop has a good selection. So that means rare games and consoles can mean a lot for a shop's status.
You're amazing, Nep-Nep. You know so much!
For that very reason, my shop had all kinds of rare consoles and games proudly on display in several cases. But as you can see, all the cases have been broken into, and they've all been stolen! My shop's already struggling because of copied games and illegal downloads. And now this...
There will be no forgiveness for that thief. As a gamer, I can't forgive this crime. They most certainly deserve death.
Nep's personal desires aside, the Basilicon will conduct its own investigation. We'll contact you as soon as we find something.
Thank you so much for your kindness.
It's gotten so dangerous lately. I hope we can go back to how peaceful it used to be here.
Honestly, Planetoon's doing relatively okay. I just got word that Leanbox is being invaded by unknown forces. Doesn't get worse than that. The bummer for us is that all air and ship transportation has been halted because of it.
That's kinda scary. I wonder if Bert's okay. I hope she's working something out.
Thank you.
Otome. What's up? You're serious? All right, got it. Thanks.
Was that a work call?
Did they find Affinex?
No, that's not it. Remember that game shop that was just robbed? Apparently, someone just tried to sell a huge lot of stolen consoles and games at another shop. Doesn't get more suspicious than that.
Then we can find the culprit using their ID!
Well, unsurprisingly, when asked for their ID, they refused and ran off. But the person had some distinct features, so it's only a matter of time before they're caught. Well, by person, I mean mouse.
The thief was a mouse?
Yep, and from the description, that mouse is probably...
Holy baloney! It's that mouse from all the other games! Let me explain. This rat's name is Warichu, and he's a small-time villain causing all sorts of trouble around the world. Having fallen head over heels for Kampa in an earlier encounter, he's been dealing with this unrequited love for quite some time now.
Well, I'm sure it'll stay unrequited forever after this.
You're not hurt, are you, Mr. Mouse?
No, I'm fine. This is nothing compared to enduring the brute strength of those pesky CPUs. But I'm not important, Kappa. Are you injured too? Even if you've been severely wounded, I'd still marry you, so don't worry, Chup.
You're so good at telling jokes. I'm not injured, so you can rest easy. It's been a while, Mr. Mouse. Why are you here in Planetune today?
To resell stolen games, isn't it? All right, book 'em, Nepo. Or Neptune.
What are you doing, Chu?
We know you were trying to resell the merchandise you stole from a used games shop. Shrinks dramatically when a mouse is suspected. You're the only one who seems to commit any crimes.
To think my popularity would come back to bite me!
I'm not sure it was your popularity that did you in just now, little dude.
Dirty.
Gosh dang it! If we don't hurry, that dirty rat's gonna get away!
No way am I gonna get caught by slowpokes like you, too! On second thought, maybe being caught by Kappa wouldn't be half bad.
Wow! It's a giant mouse! Mommy, look! A giant mouse is running this way!
Are you okay?
I hate human kids. They're so fragile. It's annoying.
rat just decked that little kid.
He's the worst. But now, that girl's gonna show up.
Hmm? That girl?
Hold it right there!
There she is.
Choo!
The heavens, the earth, the people all call! They summon me to defeat the wicked! Listen up, evildoer!
Who in the hay is that? I think I know that kid from somewhere.
Who the hell are you? Think you're so tough? Out of my way!
I am the hero known as Presto Mask! To cause a child to cry is inexcusable! I will deliver swift justice! My special move, Presto Kick! Some people are just too proud to admit their own mistakes.
Thank you, Presto Mask!
Thank you so much. How can we ever repay you?
I only did what's expected of a hero of justice. You don't need to thank me, ma'am.
The epitome of a hero. How cool is that?
So you're the ones chasing after that mouse?
That's right.
Never seen your face before. Then, as a first-time service, I'll lower the price to 1,000 credits.
What? Did you just say 1,000 credits?
Oh, I forgot to mention. But she takes money from anyone who's not a kid.
No way. How can there be such a greedy hero? I don't even have any money.
No money? Jeez, what a bum. Well, for this one time, and one time only, I'll treat it as a first-time free trial. But you better pay up properly next time, in advance, too. I'll see you all another time, then. Farewell!
Nep, you look more confused than a doggo bouncing around a leaf guard.
Iffy, a hero just demanded money for her services. I feel like I just entered the Twilight Zone.
Hey, you're always saying how the people of game industry should think outside the box more. That kid's about as outside the box as they come.
Is very out of it. Iffy, would it be okay if I took him back to the Basilicom and fixed him up a bit?
Geez, Compa, he's a thief, you know. Besides, the police wouldn't...
But I can't just leave him out here. Look at him. He's just lying there unconscious on the ground.
I understand how you feel, but come on.
Iffy, I second Compa's motion. Let's get him healed up.
You too, Nep?
It's not like we're complete strangers. We can throw him a bone, right? Besides, he's a little guy, but his network's probably pretty big. We might be able to get some more info about Affymax's next move.
Well, I guess that's true. Not a bad idea coming from you, Nep.
Oh, I know, right?
Okay, so we'll hold him at the Basilicom temporarily as an important witness.
the target!
Who's my opponent? Who's next?
Waiting! I'm all ready!
Now then, who wants to eat
me? Here we go! Yay! I did it!
Let's end this! Weak! An obvious victory!
Injury.
This is just a scratch.
Target!
have a CPU's strength.
Log Bully!
Leave this
hell.
To me! You're 10 years
turn.
Too early!
Gust of wind, but done and
here
done.
We go.
I've been waiting.
Order up.
Here. Let's do our best.
Boing.
Like a kangaroo.
Then, who's
my
next?
Turn. Here I go!
What the hell did you
I've
say?
I've been waiting! Woohoo!
Boing!
Like a kangaroo!
I'm still okay. Please look after everyone else.
Surprise attack, success! Done and
I'm all ready!
I'll nut you all up!
Order up!
I win!
Last time I went adventuring with Nep, anyway.
You can't escape! Please,
leave
give
things
up.
To me! Who's
my turn.
Nep?
Easy!
It's starting to hurt.
Let's try going here.
I'd rather not fight.
Please, the car will fall into heaven. Looks like we win!
Let's try going here.
Are you strong enough to fight me? Done and done.
I win. Let's try knitting, knitting.
Thank you.
the puppy
from Nephew Olaf!
Where
is? I can't wait!
Now then, who comes
it's
next?
Yay! I did it! Victory!
Can't we just hang out here?
Oh, Nephew Olaf!
My turn!
Oh, Nephew Olaf! I choose you! Full speed ahead! We'll lead you to
my turn!
Easy!
Looks like we win!
I won't let you escape!
Leave things to me!
Easy. My turn! Can't wait! What should I? Easy! Woohoo! I'm home!
Everyone, I've received reports from the people of Haneda City. I heard you were quite successful.
Darn tootin'. Oh, and Isti, you're not gonna believe this. There were a few guards in that town that hadn't forgotten about me.
Is that true? I am shocked there are others who remember you besides us.
By the way, has Bisha returned yet?
Bisha? No, not yet. Was she not with you?
Well...
I see. So that is what happened. Having seen her so eagerly play the part of the hero, I cannot imagine she would run from the monsters.
Hey, Isti. I'm gonna go look for Bisha.
That was pretty zen, Nutmeg. I'll come along with you to help.
Sorry, Kampa, but could you let me take this one alone? It looked like she was feeling guilty about something, so I think it might be easier to talk with her if I was by myself.
Well, okay. Just take good care of her, okay?
Definitely. I'll be right back, so wait for me.
All right, then. So while we wait for Nep, why don't we ask that rat a few questions? That dirty double-crossing rat! He made a break for it!
To think the Basilicom security would be compromised like this.
I knew I should have handed him over to the police earlier!
I'm sorry, Iffy. This happened because of me.
You don't need to feel bad, Kampa. All you did was show him kindness, and he just betrayed you for it. When we find him, I'm gonna make him wish he never did.
A wild Bisha appeared.
Huh? Neptune?
Looks like you made it back safely. That's good. We were worried when you suddenly disappeared.
Sorry.
Are you apologizing for running away, or for making us all worry?
That's, both of those.
It's all good if you understand. But don't worry. We got a little concerned, but we're not mad.
Really?
Cross my heart. I wouldn't have come to talk with you if I was. But Bisha, I would like to know why you decided to run away. If you've been keeping it from Isti, that means you've been bottling something up this whole time, huh? I just want to help you out.
Why? Why are you being so nice to me, even when I took control of this nation from you?
I guess we should clear that up first. I never thought you wanted to take Planetune from me. In fact, I want to thank you for protecting my people in my place while they don't remember me. I'm not holding a grudge at all. Unless this was your plan all along, to steal it from me.
No, I wasn't trying to do that. Please believe me.
That reaction's kinda suspicious, though. If you tell me exactly why you ran away, I'll believe that you aren't a little nation thief.
You're a meanie, Neptune.
I'm not gonna get out sneakied by a lowly elementary schooler. How do you like those cookies?
You see, I'm scared of monsters, so that's why I ran away.
Ah, I see, right. You're scared of monsters, so you ran away. Wait, are you kidding me? That's really your reason?
Yeah, that's really why.
Well, this is an unexpected development in the plot. That was the first thing I ruled out. Did you have one of those traumatic experiences?
Yeah, when I was little, I was brutally attacked by a monster. I'm a little surprised that it's affected me so much. I have nightmares all the time. That's why I really look up to heroes who fight monsters and evildoers. I thought that if I could be strong like them, I could overcome my fears. So in order to become stronger, I joined Gold Third. But it proved impossible after all. My trauma's gotten worse since I joined, and recently I've been having more monster nightmares than ever before. I used to be okay fighting the little ones, but now no matter what size of monster, I get so terrified I can't help myself. I'm a failure as a Gold Third member, let alone as a hero.
Hey, that's not true. Even if you can't fight monsters, you always save kids from baddies, right? If you're doing the best you can do, then you're not failing as a Gold Third member or a hero at all.
But because of my weakness, monsters were neglected and no one helped. That's why Haneda City ended up like that.
How about we work together from now on?
Huh?
We all have our strengths and weaknesses, and when we're at our lowest points, all we need is a friend to help us be strong again. You can take care of the city's security, and I'll take care of the monsters. That way, everything gets taken care of, all right? Although I've already decided on this anyway.
Oh, wow. I can see why people of this nation were putting their faith in Neptune.
Did you say something?
No, nothing at all. I'm gonna rely on you from now on, Neptune.
Oh, hey, while we're at it, you should call me by my nickname. We're not strangers anymore.
Is that okay? I'll call you Nep-Nep from now on, too.
So that's why the two of us decided we'd rule over Planetune together.
Yes, this is not an entirely uncommon practice. I also have no intention of raising any opposition against this decision. But my question is, why have the two of you been doing nothing but slacking off together? I swear that today I will have you to work thoroughly and pull your own weight.
Wait just a little longer, Isti. We're almost done with our one-to-one model of the Nepgeardom.
Nep-Nep, I finished with the top half of the Nepgeardom.
And I'm done with the lower half.
All right, looks good. Let's combine our parts.
Okay.
Ready? Fusion!
We did it! It's complete, Nep-Nep.
The die-cast versions are nice, but building a model yourself is pretty great, too.
Indeed it is. So, now will you begin working?
Hey, Bisha, I'd like to make another one. Do you got any recommendations?
Neptune? You said you would work after you finished making that one, yes?
How about this Nepgeardum version 2.0? It's divided into really teeny parts, but it's super easy to paint.
But, Bisha? You had said you would work after finishing the model too, yes?
Paint, is it? I think I'm up for a challenge.
Okay, I'll let you borrow my painting supplies for today. I usually charge for this, but since it's you, Nip-Nip, I'll cut you a deal.
Woohoo! All right!
I guess this is what you'd expect from two big slackers hitting it off.
But I'm glad they're getting along so well.
True. I feel like with these two in charge, their friendship is going to make game industry a much better place. As long as Istvar's stomach holds out.
seems to me. Who's next?
I'm waiting.
It's time to play
Catch. Can't wait. Yay!
Let's try going here.
leave the healing to me!
All right,
alone if I guide this many monsters here to...
Yikes! There's a ton of them!
They don't even see the trap they're walking into, too.
There are a lot more than I expected.
Is everyone all right? I hope no one's hurt.
They're finally here.
Ah! It's the escape rat.
Were you the one behind this?
You're way wrong if you think all I know how to do is steal. With my overflowing charisma and my IQ of 250, it's easy as pie to get monsters to attack this dumb city.
An IQ of 250?
Looks like Kappa shocked too. I can feel our mutual affection skyrocketing. I just know Kappa will be smitten with my smart saying, I love smart people. Please marry me, Mr. Mouse.
Hey, Yuffie, how smart are you if you have an IQ of 250?
For humans, that puts you in a class with some fairly sharp people. But for a rat, it isn't saying much.
Oh, well, I guess my surprise was wasted. So, that means Mr. Mouse is pretty dumb.
Wow, his face just went really pale. I feel kind of bad for the little guy.
Why are you feeling bad? He's a stubborn moron for not giving up his life of crime, even though he gets caught every freaking time.
Stop calling me names! You're the morons for falling for such a simple diversionary tactic!
This is a diversion?
Well, I thought something was weird, but this was your plan all along. Nep, Kappa, grab the rat. We're gonna make him talk.
I'll try my best like Nep.
Leave things to me. Tell us everything, and after that, we're gonna hand you over to the authorities.
If you do that, who knows what'll happen to your precious game console?
My game console? That was your target this whole time?
So you finally figured it out. My goal was to distance you from the Basilicom. You dumbasses fell for it so hard.
This is bad, Iffy. We need to hurry back to the Basilicom.
I'm not following. Why are you freaking out? It's just a video game. Although, if his story is true, then you're implying you have that swirl-marked console these guys are looking for, Nep.
I'm not just implying it. I do have it, Iffy.
You what?
You know that one random console I found ages ago? The one Nepgear fixed? That's it!
You idiot! Why didn't you tell us sooner? Didn't you think it might be important?
Well, I couldn't find the right time to tell you guys about it. I don't know.
Iffy, there's no point in scolding Nep-Nep right now. Let's hurry over to the Basilicum.
Right. The monsters seem to be mostly cleaned up. Problem is this guy. It's a waste of time to take him all the way to the police station. Let's just bury him here.
Whoa, that's the darkest Iffy's gotten yet.
Hey, I have a right to be pissed. This idiot's betrayed our kindness one too many times.
Ah, so you're doing this for Kampa, eh?
What? It's not like Kampa's special or anything, okay?
Hey, we have to figure out what we're gonna do with Mr. Mouse.
I already told you what we're gonna do. Nep, bring me a shovel.
Please, anything but being buried alive! Papa, please save me!
I'm sorry, but I just can't cover for you anymore.
No way! Is it because I escaped?
No, it isn't. The city is such a mess, and people were hurt just so you can steal an old console. I hate the kind of person that would do that!
Whoa! It's super effective!
Guys, I think he's going into shock.
She hates me.
Again? He got away!
Dang, he's fast. Is this the speed of a broken heart?
What should we do? Should we follow him?
Oh, just forget it. It can't be helped. Let's shift our focus. We don't know what that organization's plotting, and we gotta do whatever we can to make sure they don't get that console.
Let's try go.
I'm tired.
going.
I'm tired.
Let's try going here.
Let's do our best.
My turn.
Holy the hell!
I've been waiting. I'm all ready.
I've been waiting.
An item.
an item. There, 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 there. Are you strong enough to fight me? Yeah.
I'm good to go. Don't.
Your life here. Stand back! There's no need to waste your life senselessly. That about does it.
Over there.
That's good work, Nep. We finally caught up.
Hey, you, the ninja, hold it right there.
They caught up with me.
You were the ninja from before, after all.
You're the culprit behind Nep's console theft, aren't you? Give it up, now.
It's a real-life ninja! It's my first time seeing one up close.
I didn't expect to be found so quickly. And they are, in fact, young girls.
I'll only say this once. If you hand the console over without any trouble, we'll try and make sure you won't get treated badly. As expected of a ninja. You won't talk, let alone make eye contact with us.
Oh, no, it's not.
He seems to be saying something in a very quiet voice, Iffy.
You're right. He's mumbling, but I'm not sure he's actually saying anything.
This is a command from the general. So, even if... it ends my life! So I cannot hand it over!
Why won't you speak up? Even if you are the enemy, it pisses me off when you stutter and look away like that!
But I'm not really used to speaking with... girls!
What are you, a middle school dweeb?
Whoa, Iffy's legitimately flipping out.
Well, she has always been an assertive person who doesn't appreciate when people are vague.
Well, yeah, but Also, this guy's personality type is one we've never had to deal with before.
Uh-huh. It's always been guys who are battle crazy, or who like little girls.
Or unnecessarily hot-blooded guys, or creepy robot hackers, or old men who have strangely realistic 3D models.
Anyway, I don't know what you're planning, but we're gonna make you spill your guts.
I'll try my best like never.
Who's the target?
Has appeared.
It's my turn.
I've been waiting.
I'm all ready!
What should I do? I'll show you a CPU's power!
CPU Purple Heart has arrived!
My turn!
Can't wait! There! Time for shots! Go!
My turn.
It's my turn!
Who's the target?
Who's my opponent?
It is my turn!
I've been waiting! I'm all ready! Here we go!
I'll follow your time! Now then, who wants to die?
Leave this to me!
D-Max has appeared!
My turn!
Can't wait!
My turn.
Leave things to me.
This is nothing.
Can I have some medicine? Here we go.
Leave it to me.
I'm sorry. It's not personal. I'll take better next time.
I just keep getting stronger!
Level up! Looks like we are victorious. Return the console to us as promised.
Now, that's the one, right?
Yes, there's no mistaking it.
How careless of me to lose what I just obtained!
You're being detained at the Basilicon as a primary suspect for the crimes committed by Athimax.
If it's come to this, then...
Is he hiding a trump card?
Feast your eyes upon this!
You just scattered a bunch of books everywhere.
Do not underestimate these as ordinary books.
He just sliced up all those books? What in the world is he thinking?
Look closely.
Closely? Ugh! What are those books?
These are naughty books! There are tons of pages of books you can't buy until you're an adult!
What? Why the hell are you even carrying these around, you perv?
This is the 5 Greed Jutsu! Fall prey to your own lust!
5 Greed Jutsu? All you did was throw around a bunch of dirty magazines!
If he's right, I've seen through your lewd techniques. I'll hone my mind to keep only the ninja within my sights. That way I can easily erase those perverted pages from my vision.
Are you actually concentrating hard enough to not see the pages?
I'm not looking. I would never want to look at such perverted material.
Aw, come on, Nep. I totally saw that.
Then, the solution is to just close my eyes. It's too dark and I can't see around me.
You too, Compa. Come on, people! Stop messing around and take this seriously.
Iffy?
My jutsu is invincible! Now then, I will once again take my leave with that console. What?
Now that I remember, you said something about being shy around girls, right? What would happen if a girl was to touch you?
Hey, what's up, guys?
How cute. Even though you're a robot, you're getting so red. You must really not be used to this kind of attention. Then, if I move my body up real close to you like this, what would happen? No, cutie. You're not getting away. I have so many things I want to ask you. Isn't there anything you want to ask me? Oh dear, he fainted.
Nep, you went too far.
I'm sorry, Iffy. It slowly got more amusing to see the different ways he'd react. I couldn't help it, really.
There we go.
Well, those suspicious papers have flown off with the wind somewhere. So, let's take him back with us and...
What the heck is that?
I'm not mistaken. That appears to be coming from Planetune.
What the... That was a fast recovery.
And what is this? I have a very bad feeling about this.
A bad feeling? Wait, you can hold a normal conversation?
This is unimportant. It would be best if you all returned to Planetune as quickly as possible.
Oh no, no funny business. You're not gonna use this as an opportunity to escape. I'm not gonna fall for it.
This is not the time to argue about that. When innocent citizens' lives are at stake, we should be working together, not fighting. As a ninja, I, Steamax, will lend my assistance.
His speech and personality make him sound like a completely different person. What happened?
I know, Iffy. It's sage time. You know, sage time.
Sage time?
I bet my sexy enchantment attack shorted out his thought patterns, so his worldly desires disappeared in enlightenment.
Yeah, right. No way.
There is no time for idle talk. Hurry!
You're right. We'll have you help for now.
Then please, grab onto me, all of you. I will take us to Planetune with my ninjutsu.
Upsy-daisy!
Like this? Kampa, you're the last one. Get a move on, sister.
Iffy, where are you? It's too dark. I can't see.
Are you still closing your eyes? To me. Done, and looks like we win.
Let's try going hurting.
Be Sir Warju?
What? You mean that giant mouse?
No way. That's the rat. He looks like a final boss.
Yeah. Yeah, not possible. What kind of magic would you have to use to turn this rat into that monster?
Oh, could it be? Because he was friend-zoned?
Of course not! But whatever it is, I didn't expect Bisha to be the first to rush over here. When did she get over her intense fear of monsters?
I bet she saw the children being attacked and shook off her trauma just like a real hero would. Let's go back her up!
Newcomers?
Whoa, that was pretty rough. Hey, Bisha, I'm not the enemy.
Lady Neptune, don't get careless and don't get too close to her.
Huh?
It seems Sir Warichu isn't the only one acting strange.
What do you mean?
What? More newcomers? I'll turn any monsters in front of me into meat chunks! Don't run away! I'm gonna kill all the monsters! Kill them! Kill them!
Yikes! She's gone completely bonkers! Her change is crazier than Blonde's.
Judging by her behavior, it's possible she views us all as enemy monsters. And this may not be limited to us.
Does that mean she could look at anybody and think they're a meanie monster?
Most likely.
If that's the case, this is gonna be troublesome. It'd be fine if Bisha was just fighting the rat, but if we get in the middle of them, both of them might direct their attacks towards us.
Right. We'll need to separate them somehow.
would we do afterwards? If we don't know what's causing them to do this, then we won't be able to treat either of them.
Maybe it has something to do with Bisha's fear of monsters, but it's hard to imagine that she'd take it this far.
It's all because of that girl! Juko? It's too dangerous for you to be out here!
Do you know how those two ended up like this?
That girl had come chasing after Warichu!
Who are you?
That's not important. I'm here to help you overcome your fear of monsters. Although, you might find my methods extreme.
Huh? What do you mean?
Let's see. Why don't we start with you, Mr. Adorable Little Mouse?
What? Watch out!
Monster? What should I do? I gotta run away! But if I ran away now...
Are you scared? But if you were to run away, the city would end up in quite a terrible predicament, wouldn't it? Are you okay with that happening?
I know. I really do, but my legs... my whole body's shaking.
I see. What you need is a little more motivation.
Ooh, what a novel way to recall an event. Flashing back in time and showing us what happened instead of merely summarizing it.
The mysterious girl that came up during the story bothers me. I wonder who she is. Besides, even if we know what's causing it, what'll we do?
That's easy. We'll just fight both of them and knock them both unconscious.
Games.
But with that method, what will happen to your ally?
It's all we have right now. In order to minimize damage to the city and its citizens, they both need to be subdued. If taking them down doesn't change them, they'll at least be out cold and we can figure out what our next move should be.
Understood. And allow me to draw Sir Warichu away. In the meantime, you and the others can take care of the other.
All right. This is a bit of a tough opponent for you to fight. But you're fine, right, Nep?
I'm aware, and yes, I'm ready to go. Besides, I'm sure she didn't wish this upon herself either. It's the duty of a friend to stop her.
What? Even though you're just an ignorant monster, you actually want to fight?
Bisha.
I'm gonna show you that you're nothing but meat chunks when you try to stand against me!
This one looks formidable.
I'm grateful.
I'll attack head on!
Not yet! Not yet! I'll make you own up!
This is perfect!
Eat that! It's my turn! Cover my fart! Hey!
Let's end this.
I'll return to my favorite. Not yet.
No.
Not yet. I'll return to my favorite.
Who wants to die? Let's go!
Okay!
Not bad! I'll defeat all monsters! Eat this!
I've been waiting! I'm all recovered!
I'll defeat all...
My turn.
It's my turn!
Don't get smart,
my opponent.
Leave things to me!
Can't wait, can't wait! This can't
my turn.
Be possible!
Who's the target?
Let's end this. How's this?
Here I go!
Leave things to me.
This can't be possible.
It might be best to heal.
Can't wait, can't wait! This is the end!
I'll do better next time.
I've gotten stronger.
I just keep getting stronger.
Level up. As expected of Gold Third.
You're not bad yourself for a monster.
Bisha, please come to your senses. Can you not see? Look at our planetune. Look at all of the terrified children fleeing.
Children? If you think a monster can deceive me, you got another thing coming. Everyone here's a monster. Monsters are enemies of the children. Their enemies are my enemies, so all of them have to die.
Why won't my voice reach you? Steamax?
Regrets.
This is bad. The rat's headed towards the city.
It's a monster!
Help me! Mommy!
What can I do in this situation?
These voices!
Nep-nep, Bisha's acting differently.
Is she reacting to the children's voices?
Lady Bisha! Chuko? Don't get close to Bisha right now! She's dangerous! I can't be bothered with that at a time like this! We need Presto Mask's powers in order to save my child customers! If the children, my main customer base, are lost, then... just thinking about
she really is a shrewd business mouse.
I had to help them! Save the kids! From the monsters! I have to... Presto Mask has to save them! But monsters are...
Please, listen, Bisha. Everyone is scared of monsters. Even I'm scared of them. But you don't have to force yourself to overcome your fears. I know you have the courage to accept them instead.
Accept my fears? I see. It's all right if I'm afraid.
Yes. If you don't know fear, then you can't be a hero.
Now that Bisha's come to her senses, all that's left is that rat monster.
Then let's hurry.
Bisha, are you all right in that state? Please, don't push yourself.
Even if it's pushing myself, I can't rest. This is exactly the time when a hero needs to appear.
think he would have this much strength.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Steamax.
Lady Neptune and Lady Bisha, it seems you've returned to normal.
Yes, it's all thanks to you for luring that rat away. Bisha, if it's too much, then...
I'm fine. It was just so sudden I got a little surprised. Still, getting a good look up close, he's really huge. Anybody would be scared of this, right? But I won't run anymore, and I no longer need this mask. To hide the fact that I was scared, I wore a mask and pretended to be a hero. But no matter how long I kept the mask on, or how much golden power I carried, nothing matters unless I change myself. So as a first step towards change, I'm not running away from you!
Well said, Bisha. Allow me to take the first step with you. Let us have our premier Gold Third and CPU United Front. I'll show you the power of Planetune CPU!
Do your best. Come forth, Bandom. Bandom, activate. Maximum level.
My turn.
I've been waiting. I'm all ready.
I see them. I can see the enemy.
Now then, who wants to die?
Let's end this. Let's end this here with Neptune Break. You don't give up, do you? Then please, have some more! This is the end! Prepare yourself!
Here I go!
Who's the target? I see them! I can see the enemy!
Here I go!
Just this way! Let's end this!
This is Bisha! I'm captured the enemy!
To me!
Leave this to me!
I see them!
It's my turn!
I can see the enemy!
Let's end this!
Up, down, down!
I've been waiting! I'm all ready!
Who's my opponent?
This is Bisha! I've captured the enemy!
Let's end this!
My turn!
I see them! I can see the enemy!
It's my turn!
My turn.
This is Bisha. I've captured...
Who's the target?
I've been waiting. I'm all ready.
Let's end this.
Can't wait.
Leave things to me.
Who's my opponent? Next. This is the power of CPU Purple Heart.
Did we do it?
Yes, we've won.
We did it. We won. I didn't run away from a monster.
Isha?
It's all right. She really gave it her all. She's just fatigued.
I see. That's a good thing.
Rings a bell, doesn't it?
This is a misunderstanding. This is all that Broad's fault. I didn't go on a rampage because I wanted to.
You think we'd fall for such an obvious lie?
It's not a lie. The urge to go wild welled up from the depths of my cool guy heart.
Could you explain? In full detail, please.
Istvar! Why are you here?
I wanted to come see what all the commotion was about. It appears everything is already resolved. Now then, your name is Wadichu, yes? Without a doubt, what ultimately changed your appearance was the delusion phenomenon. This anomaly, occurring in game industry, has been shrouded in mystery, but we may now be able to make sense of it.
Transformed into some fiendish, deranged, mad scientist-type character? She was the only character with common sense in this game. How could the writers let this happen?
Neptune, I have not turned into such a character. I just wish for his assistance in shedding light on this delusionary epidemic.
Oh, why didn't you say it that way? I thought you were getting ready to dissect him.
Neptune aside, what do you think? If you decide to assist us, I'll pardon you for some of the incidents and uproar you've caused. Of course, we will only suspend your sentence.
I don't know. My pride doesn't want to allow me to help out at a crummy basilicom. As someone who's rotten to the core, being an outlaw suits me.
I see. In that case, you will forfeit 10 billion credits for damages inflicted upon Planetune, and you will be placed in custody immediately.
10 billion?
How disappointing. I would have accepted your assistance as ample compensation. I was willing to lift all charges and grant you a reprieve.
Thinking about it.
He definitely got spooked by those digits.
In fact, right now, Kampa is living at the Basilicom, so you would have constant access to her delicious meals 3 times a day.
You serious, Chu? Then I, War
Have you no pride, little rat?
Come on! Let's hurry to the Basilicon to do some research on the delusionary effect!
As usual, he flips like a coin.
Hey, by the way, where did the ninja go? He was just here, but now he's gone.
You're right. He's suddenly vanished. Using the confusion of the moment to escape, as expected of a ninja. How dirty.
It's annoying we couldn't catch him, but it's enough that we know he's a member of Affymax.
Agreed. Furthermore, if we can discover the truth, a method of retaliation will become clear. Now I am certain everyone is exhausted, so let us all return to the Basilicon. You have all done a wonderful job. That was stolen.
Do I have to hand it over now?
Well, now that we have knowledge of Affymax's target, we should store it in a secure location.
Right. Of course we should.
What's up, Nep? No need to be so hesitant about it. You're not losing anything. Why don't you just hand it over to Istvar?
Possible that you broke it? Or maybe you lost it somewhere?
Even Nep wouldn't be dumb enough to do that. He just managed to get it back. So I doubt she even had time to break it, let alone lose it.
Ooh. If he's slowly closing off my escape routes.
Wait, did you seriously lose it?
Actually, after all that fighting, I realized it was gone, but I couldn't really spit it out.
Why didn't you say so sooner? What are you, some stupid kid afraid of her parents?
I thought you guys would get angry.
Holy crap, Nep. I seriously can't believe you. I mean, I know that quiet ninja's probably the culprit, but jeez.
IF. There is no use fretting over that which has already been stolen.
That's right! We have to do something about Affymax so we can just take it back then.
It's not that convincing coming from the one who lost it to begin with.
You gotta think positively in all aspects of life, Iffy.
Do you have some sort of new CPU superpower that makes you piss people off?
What you mean?
Out of curiosity, Isti, what are Bisha and Mr. Mouse up to?
Bisha is working back at my store right now.
Chuko?
Goodness, how rude of you to act shocked towards my adorable figure.
I'm sorry, but what do you mean by working?
Her store is apparently quite popular with the monster citizens. So she is there to slowly become acquainted with them.
That's exactly right! She's gotten quite used to being around monsters lately. And thanks to Bisha, there are more human children coming to the shop! So business is booming!
That's good to hear. Wait, Chuko, why are you here?
You're here to meet with Wadichu, right?
Hey! Why are you answering for me?
Mouse? Oh no, did he do something bad again?
I thought he might be bored, so I came to offer him a game from my store. If he has real games to play, maybe he won't be inclined to pirate them as much.
That is why she has been coming here every day to bring Wadichu games.
That's amazing, Chuko!
Do you really think that's all there is to it, Iffy?
I'm guessing that's just an afterthought, and she's just coming to see the rat.
I see. So could it be, you know what?
Yep, it's probably that.
Hey! Don't get the wrong idea! As one who works at a game shop, I'm doing this reluctantly to fight against illegal pirating. For Warichu's own sake! The fact that he saved me once, or that he interests me just a little, it has nothing to do with this!
I have returned.
And the target?
Right here.
Good work. So, this is what she seeks. You have done most well. To reward you, I grant you leave. Rest well.
General, what is that thing? It looks like a normal game console. Why have both you and Lady Arthur been searching for it so desperately? General?
This is information that does not concern me.
What? Why can't you tell me? Are we not friends?
It's as I said. This does not concern you.
If that's how you're going to be, General, then I'll have no other option.
Are you attempting to make me confess?
I have here an adult book I bought as a souvenir at the convenience store. If you tell me, this could be you.
I do not need this.
What? General, what did you just say?
I don't need it. Do not make me repeat myself.
Then what about this fanzine? It's extremely rare and it sold out within the first 5 minutes of its release yesterday. And its contents are your favorite. Busty blondes.
Enough! I said I don't need it! Is that all you have to say? Then begone, Steamax! I am a busy man. I can't afford to waste any more of my time on you.
My apologies.